Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you are old here, thanks, I really appreciate. If you are new here, please kindly subscribe and turn on the notification bell so that you get notified when I upload a new video. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to design a church flyer using Photoshop. Great. These are the tests I'm going to use in this tutorial. And here are the images I'm going to use. Then scale it out. Okay, then go to Gaussian Blur. Then apply this image, then move it over here. Soft lights. Select your layer mask, select your brush, then unbrush over here. And brush over here, then reduce the opacity, then move this one over here, drag it here. Then I'm going to use soft light. Then apply layer mask and select your brush. Then brush over here. And the upper side here. Brush over here. All right. Then reduce the opacity. It's okay. Now I'm going to bring this image. Then rasterize it, hold your shift control plus U. Then go to Gaussian Blur, apply a blur to 8.0. Then I'm going to use overlay. Then apply your layer mask, select your brush again and brush over here. Also brush the top. Paste it here. Position it at the center. Then duplicate it, Ctrl J. Then copy your text. Then paste the text. Bring it to the center. Ctrl A, then apply vertical alignment. Then I'm opening this space character. Then I'm copying my text. Then Ctrl V to paste. Then close the character space. What I did is to duplicate the text. Also duplicate again. Then I'm going to change this one to white color. Then I'm going to apply this layer style. My opacity is going to be 85, the distance 6, spread 10, and the size 13. Copy the text again. Then come over here. You paste it. Then change the font. Then change the color to, the color is in the text, the color code is in the text. The color code is in the text to make use of it. This is the color I used. Then we will copy the theme. Then Ctrl V to paste. Change the font and the color to white. I'm using the font, the Jacqueline. Then copy your text again. Select your text tool. Then paste. I'm using the font Ultra Condex. it's okay like this, then expand it. All right. Select the font, the Jacqueline. All right. So here are the codes I use for the gradient fill. So here are the color which I use. Now that I have it, so there is no need to go back again. Rather, I have to continue. Then the opacity is 85, the distance is spread 14, and the size is 16. Then the inner glow, I'll make the opacity 51 and the size 79. So this is what we have. Then I'll copy the text here, then select my text tool, then paste Ctrl V. Then change the font to Poppins. Reduce the size. Then take it over here. Centralize. Okay. Draw a rectangle over here. Copy this code. Or you can use the orange color over here. Then bring in this image. Rasterize it. Then remove the background. Reduce the size and position it to your own liking. reduce the size. Then draw an ellipse too. Remove the font color. Then I'm going to use this dash dash. Okay. Then Ctrl Z. Then move it to the back here. Position it well. Duplicate it. Then apply the font color. Reduce the size. And I'll reduce the opacity. Then position it well. Then change the color. Then increase the size a bit. Then copy your text in here. Ctrl V to paste. Open the character space. Ctrl V. Ctrl C to copy. Then Ctrl V to paste. Then change the font color. Reduce the size. Move it over here. Then Ctrl J to duplicate. Drag it down. Come back to copy of text. Ctrl C. Then select and Ctrl V to paste. Change the color to white. Come over here to paste. Then reduce the size. Group and rename it. Reduce the size. I'm moving it over here. Select it back again. Use your arrow key then to move it back. Then position this one, reduce the size. Then copy your text again. Ctrl C to copy. Then duplicate, Ctrl J, drag it down, select, then Ctrl V to paste. Then make it bold. Then increase it. Tap the text TH. The font today is Jacqueline. Then move it over here. Then I'm going to reduce this text. Duplicate this one. Make it bold. Then increase it. Close it. Then increase it again. Now bring this icon, then reduce the size. Go to image, adjustment and saturation hue, then change it to white. Now group it and increase the size. Then draw a line here. Then leave this color. Use your arrow key. Then I'm going to bring this icon, reduce the size. Go to image adjustment, then change it to white. Make it bigger a little bit, okay. Then you copy your text. Then select your text tool, or you duplicate this one. Then move it over here, then select it, Ctrl V to paste. Ctrl J, You copy your test, then come here and Ctrl V to paste. Okay, now group it, then you can rename it, time and date, alright. Now copy your location, then bring this icon of location, reduce the size, position it over here. Then change the color to white. Ctrl V to paste your text. Then close the character space. Reduce the font size. Open the space. Then group it. Draw a rectangle over here. Then copy the last text. Select your text tool. Then paste the text. Change the color to black. Then make it italic. Reduce it. Then you position this light flare. I'm taking it behind. squeeze it, position it well. Okay. Now you arrange them properly. Then increase it. Using your arrow key. All right. So this is how this one was created. Then group it. I'm going to rename it. Then duplicate it. Then turn this one off. Then I'm going to bring this image here. Then scale it out. Okay. Then I'll turn this one off. I'm arranging it in order before applying or changing the colors. So now I'm changing the color. So here I'm going to fast forward. So now we are done. This is how the second flyer was made. So if you are following, please kindly subscribe and turn on the notification bell.